Oh yeah. That sucker's running.
The vacuum pump works.
Or is it?
Oh, it's on.
What?
It's on, dude.
What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So today we're gonna continue working on our custom supercar build, and there is still a ton of burnt things on the interior that we wanna rip out. And then hopefully after we get that all cleaned up, we can move onto our engine and see what's damaged there. So let's dive right in and get this sucker cleaned up. Alright guys, we actually ran to the hardware store real quick to pick up a few supplies, and the main reason is we got to get some safety equipment because a lot of people has been complaining, and
we actually need it
because we work with a lot of cars and a lot of fire hazards. So which do you think is the best
for
our shop?
The biggest one, probably the Pro Series there, right there.
Or do you want to get like two of these little
ones? Or two minis?
Yeah, just so we can have them hanging on the wall.
Let's grab two minis, man, because I know it's real important to have fire extinguishers, and we're lucky to not have a hazard issue or no fires thus far.
I wonder if this thing has like a wall mount or something.
Oh yes, we need a wall mount. Hopefully, pull that sucker out.
Oh, it does right here.
Oh, perfect.
You're just gonna weld it or drill it to the thing.
Probably to the wooden post that we got.
Oh yeah.
Boom boom.
Have one everywhere.
And we're gonna grab some other supplies too. So.
But a lot of people have been concerning about fire extinguishers, so we went ahead.
Yeah, thank you guys for your concern. I mean, it means a lot to us, and we're actually gonna listen to your advice as much as possible to try to read your comments and advice.
Yeah.
So let's grab our other stuff also.
Let's do it.
So we're also getting this brand new vacuum cleaner, 6.5 horsepower, maybe turbocharge it later for some boost or something.
Because our vacuum cleaner completely blew up.
Well, it didn't blow up, it was just sounding weird, but we got new filters. Got some more masks.
New filters for us as well.
Right.
Face filters.
Face filters. So yeah, let's go ahead, pay for the stuff, and we'll catch you guys back at the house.
So we are back. We're gonna go ahead and first install these fire extinguishers because we don't wanna catch that Lamborghini on fire once again. So let's go ahead and pop these suckers out, see what they come with.
Let's see it, dude.
Wow, nice.
Nice and simple.
You wanna go ahead and test it?
No, we'll test it in a real scenario. I think I'm ready.
We got a fire extinguisher sticker. It's all matched
decals.
Up. Decals. Inspection. I don't even know who inspects these.
I'll be the inspector on this stuff. But
definitely need to hang one up. One probably across the shop, just in case you need to run to that one or to the right one. Probably put one up on the pole. What do you think?
Yeah. Right. Oh, that looks perfect, dude.
Right there.
And it matches the toolboxes. The heater.
Everything.
So let's go ahead and set these suckers up in a good area and also set up the vacuum cleaner, and then we're going to continue cleaning.
Let's do it.
So we got rid of our 6.0 and we moved up to 6.5 with the removable blower. I don't know what that's all about, but we'll have to test that later. So let's go ahead and get back at it. Pretty crazy.
Oh yeah, how all this just comes right off, and this button still works,
dude. We may have to use that.
May have to use that burnt button on there.
Look at this. This is the reverse and the marking and
the soft top.
I guess that's the soft top right there. But dang, it's pretty cool finding out how all this stuff comes out, being able to break it. Because, like, usually if you were going to do it, like, all carefully.
Yeah, well, now we know how to do it, you know. Now if we need to take it apart carefully, it's super easy. We just had to learn how to do it. There is one big clip right here that covers this. Actually, this is a neutral if your battery completely dies.
Manual neutral switch, I guess, yeah, if you call it.
Yeah, well, that clip right there is super hard to take off. It always breaks. Been talking to a few people. So that's probably the only thing that broke. Yeah,
this right here. No matter what, it's just gonna break.
Yeah, there's a way that the clip actually slides in there, and I don't know how they do it in the factory without taking it. I don't even know how dealerships take it off without breaking it. But anyways, check that out. There's basically nothing but wires here. We still got this one little screen right here that displays the oil temperature and the coolant temperature. So let's go ahead and remove that too. If that screen's still good. Looks like it's still good, dude.
Dude, it may be. May have to use that.
May have to.
If it's possible.
Yeah, if it's possible, but looks pretty good to me. Maybe clean it up a little bit, see if it lights up.
Test it on our Lambo.
Yeah, definitely. That is legit. Maybe plug in. The battery's plugged up, ain't it?
Yeah, it is, but there's just no way for it to get juice. I guess the harness is so jacked up, but that's all right. Let's keep on removing all this nasty stuff right here. All right, guys, so we went ahead and just connected the battery and the pyro fuse that we removed. We kind of just bypassed it, and we're gonna pretty much hook up the battery right now and see what it does. See if we can get anything to turn on just for the heck of it, I guess. See what it does. Oh, what the heck?
Something made a noise.
It sounds like vacuum pump or whatever this is. Oh yeah, that sucker's running.
The vacuum pump works. What, anything in the interior?
Oh, I thought it turned on. I was like, what the heck? Or is it?
Oh, it's on.
What?
It's on, dude. Look at that. It's just messed up. But it's definitely on. It's lighting up.
Freaking sick.
Well, I wonder why this thing ain't lighting up.
I guess you gotta hit the power button. You wanna hook up that power button and see if we can just like press it one time? Come on, Betsy. I know you still got high temperature. High temperature, high oil pressure or something, or low oil pressure at least. But yeah, I guess that's all we're gonna do. We're just fooling with it. It's pretty cool that came on.
It lights up. Something works.
Yeah. Now let's just keep on cleaning.
Let's do it. Now that's probably the SRS
module.
What
is that?
Probably another SRS
module. Dude, that is awesome.
It's crazy.
Pretty wild. There's a lot of things I did not know that I'm learning as we're tearing this thing apart, and that would be pretty hard to get to, but at the same time, now that we know how to take it apart, it wouldn't be that hard.
Yeah, all it is a center console. There is a few tough clips, but that's crazy. There's two SRS modules.
That definitely looks like an SRS module.
And this one does too, so you never know. So there's probably two airbag modules controlling this whole thing.
Oh, this, I think I figured it out. This is probably for the pop-ups in the rear.
Oh yeah, that's exactly right.
And that's for the airbags.
Yep, airbags, seat belts, pop-ups, rollover. Yeah. So, or that maybe other way around, but one of them is for the rollover because it has to have its own mechanism sensing when it actually goes into a rollover stage. So.
And I'm guessing you do not have to replace that because they tucked it so far in there that I believe you could just reset it through the computer.
Yeah, Lamborghini, Audi, I think all of them can get reset with a computer. So
that's a good thing.
That's awesome. But look at that. It cleared it up. Ooh. It made this thing flat. So you can, like, if you wanted to, put a manual shifter in here.
Ooh.
You know, drill a little hole right here.
You can put like a Corvette transmission in this joint with a torque tube and stuff like that, but that's not our plans. That's just an idea.
You never know what can happen.
Yeah, you never know what could happen to this thing, honestly.
Manual Huracan.
That'd be sick. But yeah, let's keep on doing what we gotta do. There's still a good bit of cleanup. I think we pretty much got everything torn apart.
Yeah, other than like the radio and stuff like that, we're not gonna really worry about that stuff, but like everything else. I mean, I'm really thinking about taking this steering wheel off, taking this airbag out, deploying it, seeing if it works.
Deploy. I mean, I don't think it deployed. It just kind of melted.
Yeah, it just melted. It definitely did not blow up. As you can see, it's all like shrunk up in there.
Still intact. You know what I mean? It's not loose.
Nope. Still really sturdy. Just throw an aftermarket on there. Should be good to go. I didn't even know the floor was that much aluminum.
Yeah.
So just looking at all the carbon fiber, they basically just used the back firewall and
that little tube section. I don't know.
Center console thing.
Center console. What are these all panels underneath?
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. All that stuff unscrews and unbolts, I believe.
What is that?
Is that a jewel? Oh man.
Dang, this thing got burnt to a crisp.
Man, that thing should have got destroyed.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Well, anyways, check out that
fuse box.
And this is the main wiring harness right here, which we probably will be replacing, right?
Yeah, definitely. If we want to get the original engine running, we're gonna have to get a new wiring harness here.
Now that we got that side taken apart, looks really cool. Now we're gonna go ahead and jump over here, remove all this stuff, and see if it's any different.
There goes another airbag, so I guess we're gonna have another experiment, right?
We gotta put something under there and make it fly high.
Make it fly.
That's crazy. I bet this thing's pretty pricey if it was good.
Yeah, I know, man. I mean, you could probably change that cover there, but I don't know if it's even safe to allow
it. Yeah, you can see how it actually got black, like the actual airbag part.
Yes, sir. But we're making major progress here. As you can tell, we cleaned up the interior here, the floors, ripped out everything that's pretty much burnt.
Yeah.
Up front here on the dashboard, removed the steering wheel, man. It looks pretty, it's starting to look a lot better now.
We still got a few more things to remove on that side, like all these plastic pieces that are completely burnt, and then that'll probably it for the front.
Yeah, and then I think we're gonna jump to the back here, maybe like remove these gas tanks and stuff like this, all the burnt stuff back here. Look at all this, man. This stuff was very valuable if it was, this stuff would be very valuable if it was in good condition, but you know, it was unfortunate that stuff just melted.
Completely just melts everything, even melted the aluminum, which is insane. But looking at the fuel tank, it wasn't that bad busted. So I think just what's flammable, maybe carbon fiber is flammable.
I think carbon fiber is super flammable.
Or the fiberglass, I think the soft top component area, because what it was made of was the most flammable part, because this thing just completely started burning here. And then when it moved in the interior, then the seats and everything just completely just burst up in flames. But we're getting somewhere. Slowly but surely we're getting somewhere. This is probably the toughest part, is taking apart all the burnt stuff. So let's go ahead, jump on the front, remove the rest of the stuff, and then we're gonna jump on the rear end. We'll be right back.
Dude, that is pretty freaking cool. And just like that, we got some bad fuel.
Oh, there's still good fuel.
Good fuel?
Put it in our Lambo.
Yes, sir. Put it in our Lambo. Go to the strip. I guarantee you she's going to run like she's on fire. She's gonna run like she's on fire.
That's right.
But dang, dude, that gas tank is actually pretty big. I thought it was tiny.
I mean, that's not bad. You know, it's almost like a normal size.
Put the two together so it does connect right there.
Yeah, and there's the way it's flowing right now, that means there's basically half a tank on this car.
On both tanks, half a tank of fuel. That's crazy how it all didn't burn up.
Yeah, that is pretty wild.
Firefighters probably put it out pretty quick. Not quick enough.
Not quick enough for that carbon fiber or whatever else pretty much just ignited.
Oh,
but
yeah.
We do got some more damage right here to our main frame structure, which sucks, but I think we're going to take care of that and
may have to figure something out.
Yeah, we're going
to
figure something out there. I don't know what we're going to do there yet, but we got a few ideas.
Yeah, we got a few ideas. There is quite a bit of metal melting from that aluminum. You know, if you come on this side.
Oh, you're talking about... That's
how the shock tower is, where the fire got really hot. You can see all this structural components
for
this shock. So we're going to have to figure something out for this rear section. May go with something super different on the rear. May go with something super custom, you know. We don't have to necessarily use this exact frame structure. We can build something, either tube chassis or something like that,
yeah.
You know. Still a ton of it to go down before we actually start making up our mind before we do this. But... we still got to remove a ton of more stuff. As you can see, just one fuel tank.
That's
up a bunch of room.
Yeah. I think it's going to be it for tonight because we got a lot of cleanup we need to do. Usually we just pause for a second, clean up, and then we'll continue.
We got a ton of it.
Yeah. But as you can see here, it opened up a ton of room, as you were saying.
Oh, yeah. That's insane. If we do go with different fuel tanks, probably a little two aluminum fuel cells or something like that,
yeah,
that'll perfectly
for
fit
sure.
Right here. But other than that, dude, that is insane how there's still fuel in here, which is very dangerous, especially working on stuff that you're ripping apart. Good thing this is aluminum. Aluminum really doesn't spark whenever you hit it.
Yeah, I mean, it can still spark, but not as like bad as steel would.
Yes.
When you just tap it or something. It'll. Yeah.
Good thing we got fire extinguisher.
That's
that was
right.
A good call. But other than that, man, we got a ton of cleanup to do. Insane amount. So let's get straight to it.
Next day here, and we're going to continue working on the rear end here. Remove that other fuel cell and maybe some suspension components and everything else that's burnt. So let's keep on going. Alrighty guys, so now that we've pulled out the other fuel tank along with the other burnt components, we're gonna go ahead and pull this car out and make room for our engine because we really want to go ahead and inspect it, make sure it's truly a good engine because that's one of our most important components. So that's pretty much going to be a wrap for today's video. We finally got the car out of here, and here is our main focus, this engine. This is the powerhouse of our supercar build. So be sure to stay tuned for the next video where we start getting into this, and maybe the next video or a video coming soon to that series. So make sure your notifications are on. Also, guys, be sure to follow us on Instagram at Goon Squad, where you can get inside scoop there before YouTube. And if you haven't, be sure to visit GoonSquad.com, copy some merch, and support your boys. So thank you guys for all the love and support. Be sure to stay tuned, and we'll catch you next time. Peace.